Last segment of the show. Man, it flies. Let's go to Barbara in Illinois. Barbara, welcome to the show.
Well, I finally got through.
I'm glad you did.
You bet. Well, I have a lot to say. I don't know how long it'll take.
Well, let's start with one, and we'll see how far we get.
Well, I'm going to be 90 years old in October.
Oh, congratulations.
And I've been a victim of so-called government experimentation since I was 41. It took me 28 years to get the documented information, and I've been working diligently ever since, and I'm in touch with other victims all over the country. Is this the United States of America, or what is it?
Well, you know, we have a guest on tomorrow, Barbara, that suggests that this is not the United States of America. Matter of fact, he believes that he is leading the replacement government because our government has been co-opted. Tell me a little bit more about your victimhood. What were you a victim of specifically?
Well, I went to this place thinking I was going to get counseling for a problem in the family. And I was given a knockout drug as soon as I went in, and I was not allowed to awaken until I left. There was no bills came from the place, and so
wow.
I was totally in the dark as to what happened, and it's very, very serious. And I've worked since 1984. That's when I saw the 60 Minutes show on CBS.
Okay.
And I have worked very, very diligently and expensively since 1984, and I want my rights as an American citizen restored, and I want every other victim's rights restored, too.
Amen, Barbara.
Huh?
Amen. I agree with you.
I'm in touch with a victim right now in the state of Vermont. She is going to die because of what they're doing to her. This is done by electronic secret silent weapons, probably satellite, and God only knows what else. She's a beautiful person, and what she has done is way beyond the call of duty for an American citizen. And me too. Me too.
Well, Barbara, I can hear the passion and the pain in your voice. For listeners and myself, give us a little bit more. I mean, what were they experimenting on you for? What were they?
The MK,
you know, was
Ultra
there...
experiments were done all over the country, in hospitals,
okay,
prisons, universities, doctors, and dentist offices. It's all done in secret. The victim will not know that they're a victim. Maybe for years, it was about 20 years before I had any physical evidence, and then that's about the time that I saw the 60 Minutes show. So I've worked very diligently since 1984. And I think all the other members of my family are victims also, and they don't know it either. That's the way it works. If they get one secret victim, then they can find out who the family members are and make them victims too. Isn't that weird?
That is weird. Now, from your research and from your work since the 80s, do you believe that you were a victim at random choosing? You were just in the wrong place at the wrong time, or was there something that caused somebody to come after you specifically?
No. I was an absolute innocent victim. It was 1984, when I got the documented information. The government took it over. It's affecting my memory. They took it over just the month after President Kennedy was shot.
That'd be Johnson then.
What? Yeah, Johnson.
The president, yeah.
They took it over in... he was shot in November. They took it over in December after that, and then I would have been one of their first victims in January 1964. And I was drugged so far out of it that I didn't learn the name of one person while I was there. But I've
what happened to you while you were drugged? Do you know?
What?
What happened to you while you were drugged? So they drug
well,
you,
was,
you're passed out, did they?
You know, this is what? All... unbelievable to the average person, because unless you've experienced, you can't believe it. I suppose I was hooked up to a sleep machine. I've heard that there is such a thing. And that's why I did not know anything all the time. And then it was totally drugged and machine. And then before they let me go, I was hooked up to the shock machine. Did you ever hear of that?
I have heard of that, yes.
Well, that's when I died. But God had another plan for me.
Yes, he did, Barbara. You're still with us.
Listen,
you're still with us at 90 years old.
I don't want this to happen to others, so that's why I'm calling.
Well, thanks so much for getting this information out there. And go ahead.
What they're doing now is with the chip. And I'm in touch with a young man. He's not young. He's only 57. That's young to me. He said he was victimized when he was having a colonoscopy. He can't prove it because he was anesthetized, but he said that's when the problem started. They're terrorizing him off the face of the earth. He's only 40 miles from me.
And how are they terrorizing them? What are they doing to him to terrorize him?
Shock, stings, burns, horrible violations by electronic weapons, secret. And then I'm in touch with a victim in Iowa. She's the mother of twins. She's been here to visit me. This is not acceptable in the United States, and it has to be stopped. Get this message to the people, please.
Well, Barbara, that's exactly what you're doing. Do you know of any resource that people who feel that they've been a victim as well, that they can connect with people like you? Is there a victim network?
Well, Alex Jones, you're connected with him, are you not?
We are, yes, but I'm wondering if there's a listener out there right now and they said, oh man, I have a story to tell Barbara, or I have a story and I think I might be a victim. Where would you recommend people go for support and research?
Well, we've done it all. We've done it all. I'm saying now we're holding the elected officials in our government responsible for what happens to us. And also, the law enforcement has been involved since day one, so they cannot be cooperate with criminals and violate citizens that have been violated like us. They cannot.
No, Barbara, you mentioned a victim in Vermont and that they're killing her. What are they doing to her? What was her story?
She has two companies. Two California companies that they must have sent somebody out to, shall I say, that snag her? That don't sound civilized, does it?
No, it doesn't.
I don't know what they did to her, but she's been a victim ever since. And it's done by electronic satellite, God only knows what. And they're also violating her son. And he'll probably die too. What else?
Well, Barbara, I have to tell you, you know, this is a little bit outside the realm of what we typically cover, but I can hear the sincerity, the fear, and the pain in your voice. So I'm definitely understanding that this is a reality to you, and this is something that if other people are victims too, I want to do everything we can to stop this victimhood.
Okay, I'll give you this information. This is an organization that's been set up for the benefit of the victims. Imagine freedom from covert harassment and surveillance. Can you take that down?
Absolutely.
Freedom from covert harassment and surveillance. The post office box, 9022, Cincinnati, Ohio, 45209, the zip. The email, info, A with a circle, freedom, freedomfchs.com.
Well, Barbara, thank you so much for calling. I have to tell you, that is a little bit outside of our normal call. Usually I'd be talking about Barack Obama, Ron Paul, or Mitt Romney at this point, but I hear the pain and sadness in your voice. So I hope that if other people believe they were a victim of MK Ultra, mind control, subversive surveillance, and other forms of evil, that they step up and let it be known. And man, a victim anywhere is just sad, but a victim, if they're a victim to government manipulation, that's even worse. Barbara, I hope to hear you on your 100th birthday. Thank you so much for calling. Today, tomorrow, and as always, folks, may your path lead to heaven, and may freedom follow in your footsteps.